Hello and welcome, dear friends. Today I'll talk about some effective remedies for Lord Rahu. If you do these remedies, then Rahu will definitely give you very good results. So let us see what are these remedies. Now friends, please subscribe to my channel. So Lord Rahu in Nadi Jyotish and Bhrigu Nandinadi is a significator of foreign land. So if Rahu is placed in certain in the water signs, that is in Cancer, Scorpio, or in Pisces, then there is a very strong possibility that the native, will go to some foreign land, that is, will go to some place which is far away from his or her native place and will stay there. Yes, it could be some other state, a state far away from where the native is staying, within the same country. Yes, a foreign culture it could be, or it could be some foreign country altogether. Yes, and also if Rahu is in conjunction with Jupiter is the significator of the native, whether male or female, so then also the native goes and stays in a foreign place. Or even if a moon is in conjunction with Rahu, then also the native, there's a very strong possibility that the native will stay in a foreign place. It usually happens. So what we can say? So we can say that, but foreign settlement, whether it is going to be auspicious for us, whether it's going to give us good results, that will depend on whether Rahu will give us good results or not. If Rahu will give us good results, then definitely going to a foreign place, that will be beneficial for us, and that will make us even happier and more successful in life. How to get good results for Rahu, I will discuss today, and what are the remedies for Lord Rahu. And friends, Saturn and Rahu, they have a very strong connection. They're also believed in Nadi Jyotish to be friends. Now, if you also do the remedies of Saturn, then also Rahu will be very pleased. Yes, and that is if you also look after, if you be good to the to your servants, workers, to all fourth grade staff or employees, then Lord Rahu also will give you good results. You need to be kind to them. You need to be good to them. You need to be compassionate towards them. Your servants, or your helpers, you need to give them sweets to eat. That is a very good remedy for Lord Rahu. Give them food or money, help them in whichever way you can. Be kind to them. That is a good remedy for Lord Rahu. Then Rahu also is the significator of paternal grandfather and maternal grandmother. Okay, so be good and nice and loving and caring towards your grandparents. Be good to them. Always listen to them, sit beside them, provide them with moral support. Yes, grandparents, then Rahu will give you very good results. Rahu also represents all kinds of addiction. So stay away from all kinds of addiction, whether it is smoking, drinking, gambling, drugs, any kind of substance abuse, or even, getting addicted to electronic gadgets like mobile phones, television. You need to avoid all kinds of addiction. Addiction is not good. Yes, Rahu also shows, breaking down of customs. People who, flout all customs, they are also under the influence of Rahu. So, because Rahu doesn't believe in customs, it believes in breaking all norms, rules, regulations, customs, traditions. So you need to believe in social institutions. Yes, you need to believe in religion, whichever religion you follow. Yes, you need to believe in ethics, you need to believe in moral values, you need to believe in them. And that is also a very good remedy for Lord Rahu. And you need to be disciplined. If you are disciplined, then you will gain self-confidence. That will make your sun strong. And if you are disciplined, then also Lord Saturn will bless you, because Saturn also signifies discipline and hard work. So discipline, becoming disciplined in life, getting up in the morning in time, going to bed in time, that is the best remedy for Lord Rahu. Getting up in the morning and after getting up, taking a bath, that is the first thing that you should do in the morning. Yes, that will make Lord Rahu very strong, because moon is the significator of water. So if you take a bath in the morning, you come in contact with water. Yes, you should not waste water, but yes, use whatever is necessary in order to keep yourself clean. Then taking a bath in the morning, first thing after you get up in the morning, you should do that. Then Lord Rahu, moon will become strong, and if your mind is strong, then definitely Lord Rahu will give you good results. Why? Because after all, Rahu is the north node of the moon, and Rahu is illusion also. Illusion. When you have all kinds of unnecessary fear, anxiety. So that happens when your moon is weak. Yes, you have to make your moon strong. Otherwise, you may be under some kind of illusion. And that illusion will lead you to any kind of, wrong path. And it may bring about your downfall. So you need to be very careful. Yes. So some people, who have charts or in whose life, Rahu is giving malefic results. Those people, they have hallucination, and they see things which do not exist also. Yes, they have all kinds of mental aberration. They may become schizophrenic also. Any kind of mental imbalance disorder. Yes. So you need to make your moon strong. That is why, taking a bath in the morning, yes, very important. And then drinking water, yes, keeping yourself hydrated, very important. Then what else you should do, friends? I told you have to be disciplined. Then being kind to animals. Being kind to animals, that is a very good remedy for Lord Rahu. Yes, being kind to, and avoid even killing animals. Yes, that is why, if possible, it is always better to, have... vegetarian food, that is always better. But some people have non-vegetarian food now, and it is always better. The truth is truth. Yes. So if you can at least initially try to reduce the intake of non-vegetarian food, you will crave people who are addicted to such food, or who are in the habit of taking such food, they will crave for it. Yes. But over time, try to reduce the intake of such food, yes, because that also can make Rahu, there can be also, expansion there can be growth in the malefic influence of Rahu. So if you take too much of non-vegetarian food and alcohol, stay away from alcohol also. So all these things, be kind to all animals. Feeding crows and all birds, all kinds of birds, feeding crows, giving them grains, rice grains, or chapati with jaggery or sugar, giving them to eat, that is very good. Feeding ants with wheat or flour and sugar, feeding ants, that is a very good remedy for Lord Rahu. Then also feeding dogs is a good remedy for Rahu, Ketu and Saturn, all of them. So feeding dogs, being kind to all animals, that is a very good remedy for Lord Rahu. And I told you that being kind to your grandparents, and also all the old people in your family, taking care of them, yes, donating whatever you can to old age homes, helping the old people, helping the poor and the needy, and also the sick. People who are sick and diseased, helping them. Rahu also represents the people who are physically handicapped or physically challenged or mentally challenged, or also people who are leprosy patients and all, helping them. If you get the opportunity, if there is someone, some such person in your neighborhood, helping that person out, that is a very good remedy. Or you can go to those care homes where you find physically handicapped people, and you can donate something, that is a very good remedy, donating blankets and all to old people, to even physically challenged people. Yes, that is a good remedy, donating food. So all these things will make Lord Rahu strong. Yes, and also what you can do is, this Rahu also represents the southwest direction. So if you're, the southwest direction of your house, the southwest place or corner should be very clean. All the corners of your house should be kept very clean. The washroom or washrooms of your house, they should always be kept very clean. Because Lord Rahu stays there, it is believed. And also, even the south direction where Lord Mars stays, that also should be clean. Even your rooftop where the rays of the sun falls, fall. So rooftops also should be clean. Yes, so all these things you have to take care of. And if your door is facing southwest, then you have to be extra careful. Then the washrooms should always be very clean. The main door and washrooms, always you have to take care of that. In some staircases there, the place beneath the staircase, that also should be very, very clean. Okay, so all these remedies. And if Rahu is giving you malefic results, then in the northeast direction of your house, you can also put some peacock feathers there. You can keep some peacock feathers in the northeast direction of your house if Rahu is not giving you good results. And also where the food is cooked, the gas stove, there also, because there is smoke is generated there, whether it is gas stove, whether it is oven, wherever, or induction oven, whatever, wherever you cook your food, some smoke will be generated. So there Lord Rahu is present. So the best remedy is any person of the house in whose chart, you know, Rahu is not a benefic, or Rahu is not giving him good results, any person in that family, or any family member should, or even the head of the family can, you know, have at least some portion of the food, a few bites, some portion they can have, you know, there only in the beginning. First you take the food in on the plate, take it in the plate, pray to Lord Rahu, and then have some food there only, near the gas stove. You stand there only and have. First pray to him, then you have. Because Lord Rahu, no, in mythology we know that Rahu is the head and Ketu is the body, no? So Rahu only has the head or mouth. It only has the mouth. That is why Rahu represents hunger. Hunger which cannot be satisfied. Because why? Because it doesn't have any stomach, no? It doesn't have, the rest of the body is not there. So it represents a kind of hunger which is, you know, insatiable. So that is why, you know, having food there. Food is cooked there, no? You pray to him, have some food there. And then you take the plate and go to the dinner table and you have there. That is also a very good remedy for Lord Rahu. So friends, you, if you do all these remedies, no, then Lord Rahu will definitely will give you good results. And as I told you, staying away from all kinds of addiction. And people who have Rahu in the 8th house, no, they have this danger of food poisoning. If they have Rahu in the 8th house, then they have to be very careful. Never take any food, never accept any food from strangers. Never do that, because they have this danger of food poisoning, those who have Rahu in the 8th house. Those who have Rahu in the 12th house, you know, they should never go out alone in the dark. When there is darkness outside, never go out alone if you have Rahu in the 8th house. That is also very important. And if you have Sun Rahu conjunction in your chart, no, then whenever you go out in the sun, then cover your head, or Sun Rahu, any kind of relation you have in the chart, cover your head with a white piece of cloth when you go out in the sun. Yes, very important. If you have Mars Rahu conjunction, then control your anger, because your anger can lead to any kind of disaster. It will lead to your downfall. Mars Rahu conjunction, control your anger. Very important. Yes, follow all societal norms, rules. Means don't be a rule breaker, because Rahu always, you know, is that energy which will, you know, always, you know, which will, you know, tempt you to break all kinds of rules, regulations, social institutions. You need to respect them. You need to respect law. You need to respect the law of the country. You need to respect the laws of society, social institutions. You need to respect that. Yes, that is why, you know, sometimes when Rahu is also in the 8th house, then it is also seen that, you know, especially if Rahu is in conjunction with Jupiter in the 8th house, the native even may have, you know, may enter into any kind of illegitimate relationship. That is seen. Not only in 8th house, if Rahu is not giving you good results, no, then such a native has the tendency to develop illegitimate relationship. That is seen, no matter where Rahu is placed. So you have to be very, very careful. If Rahu is placed in 3, 6, 10, 11, in these houses, no, these are the Upachaya houses, there Rahu usually gives good results. Because along with time, no, the results of these houses, you get the results and, you know, there is a growth in the results. So these are Upachaya houses. If Rahu is posited there, usually Rahu gives good results. No doubt you have to also check the nakshatra in which Rahu is placed, and also the dispositor, Rahu's dispositor, you have to check. That is the sign in which Rahu is placed, and where the lord of that sign is placed, and how he is placed. That also you need to check. But friends, in Nadi Jyotish we believe that wherever Rahu is placed, in whichever condition he is in the chart, if you follow certain if you do these remedies, no, if you bring certain changes, you get up in the morning, you take a bath, yes, first thing you do, you go to bed on time, you lead a disciplined life. Yes, you stay away from addiction, all kinds of addiction. You are kind to other people. Then wherever Rahu is placed, you know, if you bring about these behavioral changes, these are behavioral remedies. If you improve your karmas, your actions, then no matter how Rahu is placed, you will definitely get good results. And you can also wear a silver chain around your neck. That is also a very good remedy for Lord Rahu. Or you wear any kind of silver ornament, that is a good remedy, because silver, okay, is this, the moon is the significator of silver. Yes, so that is why that will make your moon strong. So you can wear a silver chain or any kind of silver ornament. That will also give you, and that will make Rahu give you good results. Rahu will become a benefic for you. Bring about these behavioral changes, friends. Then definitely Lord Rahu will give you good results. Especially be kind to the poor, needy, weak, old, diseased. Be kind to them. Yes, then Lord Rahu, especially also to animals, Lord Rahu will always give you good results. So friends, do subscribe to my channel and share this video. Thank you so much.